People, they're gonna be like, what the fuck? That's right. We're in 2010, everybody.
I guess so. Yeah. Welcome.
You know who it is?
I don't.
Buddy, come on. It's Feel Like I Do, Drowning Pool.
That's not my Drowning Pool.
Oh, I know. It's not mine either.
Oh, God. That's not the song that sucks a lot. They had that video come out after that guy died, and it was pretty bad. Oh, by the way, welcome, everybody, to the 2010 Top 5 movie list or whatever the fuck.
Yeah, welcome to the pop-off.
Yeah, as you can see, we are practicing our pandemic measures. We have masked up to make sure to not infect one another.
Yep.
Or any of you lovely fans.
Little surprise for the YouTube folks. Make sure to go listen, and you're in for a treat, because we both decided to just be, I guess, dumb today.
A little bit. I thought he was going to go with his other kind of Sub-Zero style mask or his Bane mask, but I got that full mask beauty right there. And yeah, is there a story behind that mask?
There sure is. Buddy was perusing, I don't remember if it was Instagram or Facebook, and it showed Deadpool mask, and it was like, oh shit, like that looks pretty good. And it was like, oh, you know, limited time sale. And I was like, oh fuck, like, okay. And I think Christmas was like, or not, Halloween was like a couple months away. So I was like, oh shit, I could be Deadpool. That'll work. And I looked at it. It looked so fucking good. It had the black, and it looked like it was hard plastic. It looked all good. And I was like, oh fuck. And it was like, I think a $40 mask, but it was like, oh, just pay shipping, which is like $7. And I was like, oh, well, that's a fucking steal. And I was like, oh, all right, I'll use a credit card just in case shit goes awry. I can like cancel the card or tell them, you know, hey, this isn't what it was supposed to be. And, so I fucking I ordered it, and it fucking took, I think, weeks to get it, because I'm pretty sure this shit came from China. And
clearly,
I opened it, and I was like, huh, this is all cloth. It looked like it had hard plastic. And then your buddy was like, oh, whatever. I fucking threw that shit on, was like, oh, fuck yeah. Took a picture. I was smiling. I was like, I got my fucking Deadpool mask. Sent it to my buddy. I looked at it first, and immediately my heart just fucking sank. And then I sent it to my buddy, who popped off so hard.
Yeah,
because as you can tell, it is a pretty shitty little mask. It's really tight on my huge head. And this ain't hard plastic. This is the straight up whatever with stupid like fake mesh like Spider-Man eyes. So it's like not the, and it's not even like eyes. It's like two in the middle, so like I can't see like half of, I have no peripheral right here.
Yeah, well, that's pretty good. My,
I kept it for a rainy day, just in case we decided to do this.
Well, and here we are, and I still have that picture saved, because you can clearly see how happy he is under that thing.
Oh,
and,
I was
it does ecstatic not look good
until I saw it.
Yep. As you can see, I'm no glasses today, because if I put them on, this happens.
Get a little foggy fog there.
That is plenty of fog.
You gotta spray some what is that, defoggerizer or whatever it's fucking called?
Something that's to prevent it from doing that.
Yeah.
Well, I don't have any of that.
They have shit you could put on the like your bathroom mirror, so when you take a shower, the mirror don't get all foggy.
Well, don't have that right now. But continuing the tradition, you got the
coronavirus
band shirt. Fuck yeah.
Tommy Burger.
Nope.
Dim Borgen.
Nope.
Dimmu?
Yep.
Dimmu Borga? Gibberge?
Nope.
Ribbage?
Nope.
Borger?
Yeah, close enough. Yeah, Dimmu Borger.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah, from Norway.
Nope, don't know them.
Although I think the name is Icelandic. Okay.
Oh, fuck yeah.
So, this list was slim pickings for me. I didn't really have too many to that I was into here.
I didn't find anything really in the beginning, and then later on I started finding more shit. So I kind of had a big-ish, like, honorable mentions, but then I was able to slim it down to 10.
Yeah, I had two more, but I cut it down. And I could cut it down again, but I'll leave them because I don't know.
Because it got to the point where it was like, oh, I'm just putting movies I saw on here, not movies I like really liked, you know?
Right. It sounds like one of your top five lists themselves. Movies you just saw and something is happening during.
Hey,
like
buddy.
Twilight.
Hey, buddy, I fucking enjoy the fuck out of Twilight.
Yeah, I bet you do, buddy. Which, by the way, we have to watch The Last Vampire on Earth soon.
Yeah, no, for sure we do. But goddamn, I was so hard making out with her thinking of that other chick.
God damn it.
But yeah, no, I know. I'm a piece of shit for that. I admit that. I know that. She never found out, so hopefully it stays that way.
I mean, you were a young growing boy. It's whatever.
I think I was 18. I was a man.
Well, legally. Wait,
2008? I was 19 then.
We have a lot of growing still to do when we're 18.
I'm still growing.
Oh, I know. Just, you know, horizontally.
All right, what's your number one?
My number one, buddy! Jesus!
Fuck this.
All right, I guess I'll do my honorable mention because I have seven.
Yeah.
First up, Iron Man 2.
We'll see you.
I assume we're going to talk about that later because my buddy fucking loves himself some Iron Man 2 for some ungodly reason.
But you know we'll talk about it later.
Yeah, god damn it. Man, fucking thing. Next up, we have Despicable Me.
That was one of the ones I took off, but it's a very good movie.
Yeah, gave the world the Minions. I don't know if that's a good or bad thing.
Yeah, it's so fluffy.
That too, yes. I'm sure my buddy has been described that way before.
No, not fluffy.
Oh, really? Okay. Isn't that what that fat comedian says to make himself feel better?
Yes, that's Gabriel Iglesias.
Yeah, there you go. Didn't he lose weight then put it back on?
It sure looked like it.
Yeah, he looks just as big as he always has. He sure does. Yeah, next up, we have Inception.
Okay, I'll talk about that later.
Okay. Next up, we have The Other Guys.
All right, delete that off my honorable mention.
Okay, so we'll talk about that now. Yeah, it says Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg, and for a little bit, The Rock.
Yeah, not bad. The Rock and Samuel Jackson. So it's like, oh man, this is a stacked fucking movie. And then they their egos got way too big for reality, and they ended up dying because they jumped off a fucking tall ass building.
They thought they could survive it, buddy.
Aim for the bush, you know it, and then fucking just. And I was like, oh my god.
God damn it. I think some of the biggest pop moments was Michael Keaton working at Bed Bath & Beyond.
When he kept putting in like TLC references,
yeah,
that was like, you know, hey, don't go chasing waterfalls, and they're like, come on, like really?
Yeah, it doesn't even make sense.
Yeah,
this is the first time I had seen Michael Keaton since Multiplicity.
Really?
Yeah, I can't think of anything else he did before this, besides Multiplicity.
Well, Beetlejuice came out in what, 1991?
It was like 1989 or something.
Was it?
Multiplicity came out like at what, 1997 or something?
I thought that movie was old. I thought Multiplicity was 1980s.
No, you're thinking of Mr. Mom.
Oh, no, yeah. Alexa, when did Multiplicity come out?
Oh, it's close.
You were close.
And I can't think of anything. Like once other guys came out, he started popping up in everything. It's like he took a break and then came back.
He was Vulture, or no, he was Birdman. Then he was Vulture.
And then he did that McDonald's movie that was pretty good.
Oh yeah, The Founder.
Yeah.
First saw it.
That's not too bad.
I believe it. Business side of it.
Yeah, I've seen The Other Guys once. That's all I remember, basically.
It's pretty funny.
The Rock dying at the beginning and Michael Keaton. Next up, we have The Expendables.
I took that off mine. That was
right. This is a culmination of a bunch of action stars, mainly starring Sylvester Stallone.
Yeah.
And Jet Li was in this one, right?
Yes.
Bruce Willis was not?
He had a cameo.
Okay, him and Arnold had a cameo.
Him and Schwarzenegger had a cameo, because Schwarzenegger was governor at the time.
Yes.
And then Bruce Willis was just a cameo.
Yeah. So it was later on that they had bigger roles.
Yeah.
Since he wasn't governor.
Dolph Lundgren, Jason Statham, Terry Crews.
Which, by the way, I forgot there was we talked about the Punisher War Zone and like we were rating our three Punishers, but actually there's four. Dolph Lundgren was the Punisher.
Yeah, yeah, I don't count that movie
never
at all.
Never saw
it. 89, 88
Yeah, I had never seen it, but he was a Punisher.
Yeah, you can't hide that accent, so not my
absolutely
Punisher.
Not. If he dies, he dies.
God damn.
Next up, we have Jackass 3D. All
right, delete that off mine.
I honestly don't recall. I don't know if I've even seen this one, but it's, again, it's like they just fucking blend together.
This is the one where he, Bam would, like, pour water on somebody, and they'd look, and he'd sock them, like the Rocky. He would pee on people.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
And lastly, we have Black Swan.
I didn't see that on mine. I didn't see that at, on the list at all, but I saw that movie once. Didn't care for it.
I also saw that movie once. I don't remember anything about it other than Mia Kunis was like went down on Natalie Portman. And that's why it's on the list.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Shut up, Meg, and lick my pussy.
Oh, can you imagine, buddy? She said that. This mask could give me trouble.
Right. I know.
It's like moves it down.
My beard's starting to poke through it, and it's really fucking itchy.
I can feel mine right here and here.
Yeah. Yeah, it's very odd. We might have to stop this. It's not fun.
I might pull it down. Yeah.
Or yeah, really take it off of me. Okay, my list, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 left after I took off your couple. I have a Tron Legacy. I know a lot of people say it's fucking awful, but I liked the music and I liked just the way shit looked. I really liked it.
I saw it for the first time a few months ago and I did not care for it.
Yeah, that was when they first started doing the whole, like, oh, the youth CG. Like, it was rough back then. If they could redo it, if they could redo it now with how they did RDJ and Avengers, like, that looked pretty fucking good.
The current Disney tech.
Yeah, but...
I was going to say, with Disney tech, but, like, wait, this is Disney, technically.
Yeah, but this was them starting it, so then they finally got it right, like, Avengers and shit like that.
Yeah. Which, but, I mean, it kind of fit with this movie because they're in a game. So it's fine if he looks like a fucking game character.
Yeah, but everybody else was real. It's not like everybody else looked shiny like a game.
They should have done that.
Yeah, they should have. Yeah, they should have put a layer on everybody else to make them look kind of plasticky.
Yes.
It would have fucking blended right in. Next, I have a great action movie called Machete.
Okay, we'll talk about that later.
next is Scott Pilgrim versus the World.
I had it on there, but I got rid of it because I just don't remember much about it.
I like the music, and like he just had to defeat like seven evil exes, and it's just it's good time. It was like straight up like they made it like a game because like you would get coins and shit, and like it was just a fun thing. It wasn't like it wasn't taking itself too seriously, but it wasn't taking itself too fucking fake.
Uh-huh.
Next is a movie that surprised the hell out of me. I went in there with the lowest expectations whatsoever and came out laughing my fucking ass off. MacGruber.
Yeah, I saw it on the list, and I have still not seen that, but I've been meaning to. I know there's a part where he fucks a ghost.
Oh, that's one of the greatest parts. Another... God damn it, he still comes way too... He's like... he comes, like, so fast.
Well, at least he comes.
Val Kilmer was the bad guy before he got all, like, not talky. Uh-huh. And it's fucking hilarious because there's that one part where he gets, like, scared and he, like, screams like a girl. And then MacGruber kills him by throwing him off a mountain and then he just straight, like, pisses on him. He just, like, whips it out and pisses over the cliff onto his dead body.
All right.
Next is Kick-Ass. Only because of our boy.
Talk about that later.
Next is... Hot Tub Time Machine.
All right. Not seen it.
It's funny. It's just like, I like the people they picked, and it's just like, you know, like, what if you could go back to when you were younger? You know, they're all middle-aged and shit, so it's like, it's just, I don't know. I liked it. It was a good movie. Way better than the second one.
Haven't seen that one either.
Yeah. That one's whatever, but at least see the first.
All
right. Next is Shutter Island.
Okay, we'll talk about that later.
Oh, God damn it, dude.
What the fuck's on your list?
You'll see. And then last is The Book of Eli.
Not seen it.
It is with Denzel Washington, and it's pretty fucking good. A little slow, but the action moments are pretty action, but then it's, like, slow.
Mm.
What do you call it? Gary Oldman's the bad guy. Mila Kunis is in it.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it's not the greatest. Her isn't great, but yeah.
No, it's like movie's... it's like I said when Forgetting Sarah Marshall was on the list. I said that this is the short period of time where people thought she could act, because now you don't see her anywhere.
That's very true.
She's also been Kutcher'd, so
I can't remember the last thing I've seen her in.
Ted 2.
No, Ted 1.
Was she not in Ted 2 even?
No, Amanda Seyfried was in Ted 2.
Oh my god!
They explained that
Farland.
They explained that they broke up, and then he's been single for 4 years, and then he started liking Amanda Seyfried because she was the lawyer for Ted.
Oh fuck yeah! I've seen that one once.
They're not bad.
It wasn't as good.
Flash.
Ah! Yeah, I saw Flash Gordon recently too, and that was not great.
I bought it, so we'll review that soon.
Oh god, I almost fell asleep quite a few times. It was really boring.
He's a fucking football star, buddy. He's saving the galaxy.
No, I know, buddy. I know it sounds like it should be awesome, but
from what? Fu Manchu?
It's just too old.
Wasn't that the bad guy, Fu Manchu?
Something like that.
All right. Ready for my number 5?
Yep.
All right. Let's go ahead and go with this one.
Okay. Nothing.
So slow.
Yeah.
All right. Let's go with this one.
Don't hear anything.
It's not.
No idea on this.
There's a very... Come on, there's gotta be... There's one song that's...
You just tell me, buddy.
Inception.
Oh, fuck yeah. You should have played the... Blong.
That's what I was looking for. That's what I was thinking would play.
Well, apparently not, buddy.
Yeah, apparently not. But yeah, no, this... I saw it again recently. Still just as confusing to me, but I still get it, but it's kind of like... It is kind of a watch it once and done. It's not really one you replay.
Did that come over?
There you go.
That's a text tone on my phone, buddy.
That's what it's most known for. It has the beautiful Ellen Page in it. It has the guy who
before she was before she was exploited by David Cage.
Oh well, that they modeled they modeled a fake body.
That's no, I know, but yeah, but she wasn't told that was going to happen, so she had quite a fit about it. And I'm pretty sure she sued them or was going to.
Yeah, well, the game sucked anyway.
I didn't like,
Buddy, I played a couple levels, and I just, that was it.
But Willem Dafoe is in it, buddy.
Buddy. No.
It was the best game since Heavy Rain.
Buddy, no. But, our boy, Leonardo DiCaprio is in it. Tom Hardy's in it. The usual suspects, sure. Michael Caine.
Ken Watanabe.
Yeah, I was gonna say that Asian fuck.
Okay, he has a name.
Cillian Murphy, he's in it.
He is, yes.
Yeah, pretty solid fucking movie. They have to go inside a dream, within a dream, within a dream, to
gonna
plant.
Be honest, I was starting to exacerbate under there. Woo! I was getting rough.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm starting to slow down too.
Yeah.
I already got the app.
That's a nice little collar. This is like Jericho.
Yeah. Lucky, your buddy gets choked to death by that stuff because my neck is really big.
Yeah, that's true.
So yeah, like pretty solid movie. I'm gonna take mine off too.
Yeah. I know the people are still questioning. Did the top keep spinning? Did the top fall? What does that mean? Is he in a dream?
Oh, the ending.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's. I guess he said he did that to leave it up to. The viewer's interpretation. Mm. I think personally he was in a dream, because earlier when they were testing out, can you hear me still?
Yeah, a little bit.
earlier when they were testing out the
fuck yeah,
what's her face as the architect or whatever, he ran to the bathroom and spun the top, but someone startled him, so he knocked it to the ground and just picked it up. So I think since then he was like in a dream still. Because, like, how long has he been gone? And at the end of the movie, his kids are the same age, wearing the same clothes in the same situation.
Yeah, I don't remember, like, much about it.
Yeah, no, I think it was he was still in a dream. Most he just likely. Chose to finally accept it because he has nothing else. He got rid of
We live inside a dream.
Got rid of Mo or whatever the fuck her name is.
Ah.
Maul. There we go. That was her name, Maul.
Oh. So now instead of looking at the computer, I'm like looking at my phone trying to look for my movie song.
Fuck yeah, that's why I kind of held my phone up.
Yeah.
Hope everybody likes my Hawaiian-ish shirt.
I don't care about the family plan and YouTube Premium. Oh, I wouldn't write my buy YouTube Premium.
I'll add you to mine.
God damn it.
No, I don't have family. I just have personal.
You've done enough for me, buddy.
Yeah, I got you YouTube TV, buddy.
You sure did. Appreciate that.
I'm glad you do. That legit makes me feel good.
Fuck yeah. All right. We're going to move on to my number 5.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Sounds punk.
Yeah, sort of.
I don't know. There's so many goddamn... Oh, fuck yeah. I don't remember that fucking in there.
Apparently. And I'd be honest. I've seen it once. I don't remember much about it, but I remember this. So this is why it made the list, because it had Michelle Rodriguez in a bikini top.
Oh, for sure.
So that is why it is on my list. It was a rough pickings, like I said. I had like 4 down, and I was sort of okay with them, and I was like, what the fuck is number 5, though? I can't make my fucking decision. Like, Inception, I guess it's pretty good, but I don't remember a fucking thing about it. Machete, Michelle Rodriguez made the cut.
Yep. Based off of that fake trailer from Grindhouse, they made it into a movie.
That is true.
And I enjoyed every minute of it. Movie started with him saving some butt-naked Mexican chick who had a nice ass.
Fuck yeah, and, as all movies should.
Yep, and then he escaped the hospital by using a guy's intestines to repel to the next... yep.
I remember that.
The second one, you remember that chick from Spy Kids, Alexa Vega?
Yes, I do. That's why the second one will be on my honorable mention list.
Alexa, stop.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, no, the second one, she was just in a straight up fucking thong, and it's like, oh.
Yeah.
Masterpiece.
Which is very odd, because Robert Rodriguez directed her in Spy Kids when she was a kid.
But it's fine. She's an adult now.
I know, but it's something odd about it.
Buddy. Like that ghetto chick I knew when she was 8, and I would still fuck her now. I mean, I would fuck her now.
Yeah,
still.
Yeah. That was a very no, you still would.
No, I
know, buddy. You're desperately trying, and you had the. Did you have a date or something? Did you meet up for food?
No, she never texted me back, and she hasn't texted me since Friday. So that's going on the depression cast.
I didn't know that. Now we got to do a depression cast.
I know. We said we were. We're doing we're doing the movie review tomorrow.
What?
I thought we are doing it today because we moved the movie review to tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's fine.
Ready for round number 4?
Yes, I am.
Let's do this one.
Okay, sounds like a school movie. Have I seen this?
I don't think so. You saw technically the first one. It's from a band called Infant Sorrow.
Okay.
Oh, that doesn't ring a bell.
Sure doesn't.
God,
it sounds kind of punkish. I don't listen to punk.
Get Him to the Greek. That was the sequel to, well, quote-unquote, sequel to Sarah Marshall.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I never saw that.
It was, God damn it, it was about, it got that fucking fat shit, because this is, like, the fattest I've seen him. Jonah Hill taking Russell Brand, who was Aldous Snow, to the Greek Theater for, like, a anniversary concert.
Two people I don't really care for, so I didn't see it.
Ah, but it's good.
I saw Jonah Hill's pretty good in Moneyball.
Never saw it.
Oh, I know, buddy, but get ready. Once we get to that year, number fucking one.
God damn it. All right. Right. What is your number four, buddy?
Oh, shit. Hang on.
I know.
What is my number four?
Now I can see you forget about it.
Oh, there we go. Hang on.
Not fucking prepared.
Well, we barely talked about it. I thought you had to say more about it. Oh, fuck yeah. I knew what I want. Here we go.
And you don't care. Raid Shadow Legends.
I have a 15-second ad I can't skip.
Oh, man. They're getting worse with that,
this
huh?
This is about the cloggers.
The cloggers?
Yeah, there's they have a clogging problem. There's people clogging upstairs.
And it's they're fucking the like answer. Dutch clogs.
Yeah.
God damn.
Here we go. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Sounds like Last of Us.
It almost sounds like the beginning of a Linkin Park song, you know.
It's way better than that.
Buddy, you don't know.
Yes, I do.
I can't tell with the slow ambient music.
Yeah, let me skip ahead. It's probably all going to be like this, though.
I don't know. There's so many movies you said. Oh, we'll talk about it later.
I know.
Talk about it later. I can't remember.
This is Shutter Island.
Oh, gotcha.
Directed by Martin Scorsese, starring Leonardo DiCaprio and I think John Carroll Lynch. Isn't he in this? Isn't Drew Carey's killer brother in this?
He might be a guard, but I don't remember
that's
being
what I
this
think.
In a long time.
No, I'm picturing him in my head. I can't think
Mark
of
Ruffalo.
Any else starting it. As who?
Mark Ruffalo, he's his partner.
Oh, that's right, yes. This is a like a crime mystery
and
movie.
And what? It has the guy who played Casey Jones from the original Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie.
Yes, it does. Who is so old.
Cove? His name starts with a K, I think, his real name.
Hmm. Yeah, it's another movie where I saw once. I really enjoyed it, and I would watch it again, but I have not. And I remember there was like a twist at the end, which
it's
like the same
fucking good.
It's like the same kind of twist that's in a whole bunch of movies, where it's like, oh, I was this person all along. You didn't know it, but it's still pretty good. It's Scorsese, so you know the direction is solid, and it's DiCaprio. So what do you want?
Yeah, exactly. No, it's really fucking good. I remember the ending confused me, but then I understood, like, oh, he's pretending to be the character so he can get lobotomized because he knows he's, like, an evil person for what he did. So it's not bad.
Maybe that's the answer to your problems.
A lobotomy?
Yeah, forget all about your pain.
Give it a fucking shot, buddy.
Maybe it'll help you come.
Yep, just fucking jam a rod just fucking straight in there.
Yeah, just like in Total Recall that I just watched yesterday.
Sure.
Fuck yeah, which you have not seen, as I learned.
No, I've seen parts.
He hasn't seen Total Recall, everybody.
I saw the three tits. I saw when he's out on the surface, like, and then I saw, like, the beginning when he, like, just injected him, and then he's like, what are you doing? And then he's all, like, spy mode.
I remember has Michael Ironside in it as well.
Oh, yeah.
I'll see you at the party, Richter.
Yeah. The fucking remake, though, pretty good.
Buddy, really?
That would have been on the list.
No, it wouldn't have been, buddy.
It's on my list. It'll be on my list, yeah.
No?
Yeah, the new one, Total Recall.
I didn't realize this, but in the movie, like a guard who's with Michael Ironside have like a little scene is played by Mark Alamo, who of course, as we all know, played Gul Dukat in 7 seasons of Star Trek Deep Space Nine.
Consider that a divorce.
What have you been feeding this thing, blondes?
Alright. Ready for my number 3?
Do you want to hear more about Gul Dukat?
Ready for my number 3?
No? Okay. Sure.
Jesus. Please don't say anything.
pretty, buddy. It's so fucking loud, I couldn't hear anything.
Thank God. Hold on, because it said that version, but then it's doing something stupid.
Okay. Oh, there it is. That's Iron Man 2. He wants his bird.
You fucking know, buddy. Iron Man 2 with one of the greatest villains ever, Whiplash.
Is it, though, buddy? Is it really?
It really fucking is.
It's
way
not.
Way better than fucking that, like, Cold Soldier, whatever it's called, and all this other fucking a Dark World and shit like
Winter,
that.
You mean Winter Soldier, the best film the MCU has made, period?
It is.
That one?
It is fucking good.
Right, sure.
No, it is.
The best part about Iron Man 2 is Hammer, who's, for some reason, his name is escaping me.
Justin Hammer. Oh, the actor's name?
Yeah.
Fuck, he dances in everything.
He sure fucking does. Charlie's Angels in this.
Shit, what is his name?
Right?
It's like, it's one of those names where you're going to hear it and be like, oh yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to, let's see. Oh, I searched Justin Hammer and I got a real estate agent.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Sam good. Rockwell. I got it before I saw the name. I saw his face. That's what I needed. I'm looking at Gold Ducat on this screen. I'm looking at Sam Rockwell on this screen.
But yeah, no, it's yeah. And then, Hammer Industries. I wish they would have played a bigger part.
Yeah, I know. They came back sort of later.
Why are you screaming? God, nobody cares.
As you can see, this is Gold Ducat. It wasn't canceled, buddy.
Like, no, can I stop it? Can I not video fucking?
You just don't accept it. This is Gold Ducat. He's a Cardassian. It's obviously they call them spoonheads. That's the racist term for them. Oh, okay, I guess we're done.
Yeah, no, it looks.
The video's done, buddy.
Yeah,
there
I turned it off. Yeah, no, all right, I'm done.
I want everyone to know what I was talking about.
No, he looks like a stupid snake. He looks like a fucking piece of shit.
Buddy, that's the idea. All right. I did that earlier, too. Just dicking around.
Yeah. I'm not paying attention, either. Ready for my number two?
But I didn't do my fucking number three.
Well, then fucking do it.
There's no Star Trek person in this, I promise. Hang on, here we go. Number three.
Turn off the fucking background.
Wait, what?
Turn off the... I don't want to see the screen no more.
Oh, are you still sharing?
Yeah, you are.
How? Normally, I end it.
Yeah, end it.
I thought, the screen on my thing changed, so I thought, like, you turned it off.
Oh, no, I can't turn it off. I was trying, otherwise I would have sooner.
Oh, no, I thought it was already off. My bad. All right, here we go. Number three. It's fucking low. Even lower. God damn it, it's just this, the whole thing.
I don't know. I can't hear anything.
Yeah, this is, let me see if they get the full title. The Human Centipede, First Sequence.
Oh, fuck yeah, we'll talk about that later.
God damn it! Okay, I guess we will. What's your number two, buddy?
Two. My number two.
All right. I'm guessing it's not the Human Centipede First Sequence.
Hold on. Come on.
Oh, fuck yeah, it says his affiliation is the Paw Race. That's pretty cool.
Come on. How is this going to be a title for it, but you're not going to actually have the thing in there. Let me see if I can find...
Just tell us, buddy. The anticipation is,
Oh, you know, buddy.
Hold on.
Share my screen again.
Oh, fuck yeah, I got a phone call. Hold on. This one. Can you hear it?
Yeah. Oh, god damn it. I saw it. Fucking A. Yeah, I know what this is.
You're fucking right. One of the greatest remakes ever made.
No,
Jackie
no,
Earl
it wasn't.
Haley.
It was not. No, it was bad.
No, it is not.
Yes, it was bad. I fucking saw this in the theater. I didn't have to pay, and I still felt like I was cheated out of my money.
Oh, I got my money's worth.
Yeah, I bet you did.
It's such a good movie. How did you not like this movie? I don't understand.
Because it's buddy, have you seen the original?
No.
Yeah, perfect. My point is made right there.
I just saw what's-his-face Johnny Depp die.
I bet. Right, so what am I even going to... I'm not even going to bother conversing with you.
It's not that great. I mean...
Buddy, it is. You've not seen...
Well, Dory, we'll watch it for this horror coming up.
Getting real hot.
We'll watch all the classics for our third annual 31 Days of Horror.
Yeah, and...
Scared.
Oh, fuck yeah. I'm reusing that. I think I'm not.
God, just change
I'm gonna
the...
Adding on to it.
Ah.
What's that? Still scared?
That's how you change. I'm like,
Still thinking of leaving? You still fucking nuts? And then another Chucky laugh. All right, here we go. I'm just going to assume you're done. Here we go. Number two.
You're making me done, yeah. I know what this is, because that sounds really familiar. I just can't think
of it.
I can't think of it.
This is Kick-Ass.
Oh, fuck yeah.
And it is number two for mostly one reason and one reason only. Does my buddy know?
Yeah, that's the same reason why I had him, too, was for Big Daddy.
That's right, Nicolas Cage. Ah!
Who was like, this was like his first good thing. He had like a real like long downfall of like not so good shit. And then all of a sudden he came out of nowhere in a supporting actor role in this. And it was like, oh, he's back. But like, not really. But he like, at the time I was like, he's back.
Well, he's definitely back now with hits like Mandy and Color Out of Space on his belt.
For sure.
And the soon to be Tiger King movie, which is... That'll be something.
Now, is that a movie, or is that like a TV, like a Netflix movie?
I have no idea. It didn't
There's
say.
No way it could be but a movie.
What are you more excited for? To see Nicolas Cage as Joe Exotic, or to see Thor as Hulk Hogan, brother?
Oh, more Nicolas Cage for sure.
Yeah, just because of the craziness. But I'm also very curious of how Thor is going to pull off Hulk Hogan and how Hogan he's going to be in it.
He's not that big, though. Like, Hogan was
he'll
huge.
Get big.
He's not going to get as jacked as fucking Hogan.
They'll do CGI bullshit like they did with Evans. It'll be fine. Oh, fuck yeah, brother. Eat your vitamins, dude. God damn it. See, we're going to be disappointed, though, because we're going to have, like, 5 minutes of him being Hulk Hogan and, like, 120 minutes of him being Terry Bollea.
Right?
Yeah. Who's going to play Macho Man? Oh, can we theorize? We tried that before. Huh?
His brother. Liam Hemsworth.
You know what? Probably, buddy. Probably. Fucking Mark Ruffalo.
Oh, god damn it, dude.
bring back the... Or actually, you know what?
All the dots. They just CG him like the Hulk.
The chick who played Valkyrie will be Macho Man.
Oh, fuck yeah, buddy. Because the yeah, gender swap, it's all good.
They're in everything
what
together.
What you talking about, sister?
Oh, fuck yeah. No, she's playing a man. She's playing a dude disguised as another dude. The bigger question, though.
Can't do that
Will they have that Macho Man rap song, the diss track towards Hulk Hogan?
I don't know what that is.
You don't know what that is? No, hang on.
I
really need a keyboard down here.
I can't stand 80s wrestling, so.
Buddy, they were in the 90s, too.
I just realized, I look like I sell coke or do coke.
This with shirt's the shirt?
Not, yeah, the shirt's not helping me.
Oh, I know.
Only, like, fucking cocaine users have a shirt like this.
That is true. Is this it? Okay, yeah, this is it. Hang on. There's like a music video of it. Maybe there's not.
That's so bad.
Hang on, buddy. We're doing this live.
I'm hanging on.
Get fucking ready. Little off-ramp here. This is what we do in the TJU.
Fuck yeah, me just looking at my phone.
You can look at your screen, buddy. Buddy, I shared my screen.
Yeah, I'm in the way. There we
okay.
go.
Okay, well, you didn't tell me that it was on. You gotta tell me that, because it doesn't tell me if it's showing.
And this is really him? Or yes, did somebody make a song out of his promo?
No. He did a rap album.
Oh.
There's more. Wanted to fight him in a shoot. He wanted to beat the fuck out of Hogan, like, in a ring or something.
All right.
Yeah, pretty good. God damn, Macho Man was so good.
God damn it.
He was. All right, hang on, let me stop the... There we go. A little bit of trivia for our fans who don't know about Macho Man.
Yeah, I sure didn't.
Well, I don't know how you didn't hear that.
I don't like 80s wrestling, so I haven't looked at anything about God or from.
You like... God damn. Oh, fuck. I have notifications on here, and it's just from your fucking comment.
Oh, what, Facebook?
Yeah. Oh, that fucking guy who I showed you his comment before was like, oh, now I get that all the time, where he said, let's go. Never give up. Hope you're staying safe. I would love to be friends.
Oh, yeah.
Then we have one from a Sandman Rios who said, wow, these guys are absolutely amazing. Can't wait for more of their amazing content. Wonder who that is.
Fuck yeah, I don't know. A true damn fan.
It. Yeah, to the end.
Fuck yeah. We are your buddies.
We are your friend. Go listen to that review, everybody. We had the entire theater to ourselves.
It's pretty fucking good, and I did not share my pizza with him.
No, he did not. We should have been recording like throughout most of the movie.
Oh, I didn't even think about it. We should have.
Yeah. All right. We're on your number one now, which I think I have an idea of what it is.
Well, we'll see, buddy.
Yeah. I'll let you play a song, even though we know.
Ooh, creepy.
Sounds like a horror movie. About a German doctor.
So it's not really horror, but yeah.
I mean, it is. It's in the genre.
I mean, I guess. I wasn't scared. I was thoroughly entertained.
We're not scared. We're fucking men. I'm going to be scared by a movie.
It's the Human Centipede, first sequence.
I've been genuinely scared by movies since I was like 8.
Get ready for fucking second sequence.
The second sequence is legitimately actually a decent movie.
Oh, it's pretty fucking good.
It's interesting the direction they decided to take it.
Yep.
But this is first sequence where the world was first gifted the idea of making a centipede out of 3 human people, where you have one guy at the front bent over with his tendons and his knees cut, someone else with their mouth sewn to their asshole, and then another person behind them to be the tail end of the centipede.
Yep. Pretty fucking good, because he would cut the ass cheek and then sew it to the face, so it was like that. So you're legit stuck on the asshole.
It's like an evil flower.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
A very beautiful evil flower.
Yeah, so the idea is that they'll survive by the front end eating food and it passing through the digestive tract into the other two, which doesn't make any sense whatsoever.
It's not how it works.
It's not exactly how it works. Well, it doesn't end well for that doctor or the centipede. No.
Or that girl. That sucked for her.
Yes.
Yeah, because, shit is fucking the food that doesn't have any fucking nutrition in it. So she's eating the shit. She's not getting anything from that.
No.
And then eventually, you know, so the Asian dude ends up fucking hottie currying himself because he's like, fuck you. And he, like, kills himself because he didn't want to make him happy. And then the fucking middle chick was like, oh, no, now we're stuck. And then the back chick was dying from, like, what's that blood disease from, like, surgery?
Oh, anemia?
No, that's a loss. That's a, like, lack of blood.
I don't know.
She was, like, sick from the blood. I forget what it's called, but she died. So now the chick's stuck in the middle. And then two cops found the doctor, and I think he killed one cop, and then the cop killed him, but he killed the cop as he was dying.
Everybody died, yeah.
Dead, and the chick just stuck there and stuck with dead bodies on both sides of her.
Yep.
Pretty good.
Yeah, not bad. I can't not hear, though, South Park in my head. Do I eat the cuttlefish or vanilla paste?
I know.
It's South Park ruins everything, like, in the best way.
That's pretty good. Yeah, fucking sent to iPad.
Yeah, they were having a hard time in the booth. There's behind the scenes footage of them recording that.
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's hilarious.
Not too bad. Yeah, you'll be hearing from us in I think the second one came out the next year. It's either next year or 2012. Maybe. It came out pretty quick.
I think this one was already made. It just took a while to get released because nobody wanted it. This is like these three movies are the only movies that like Tom Six has like ever done. As far as
I know. The only ones I know, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So should we wrap it up with my number one?
Might as well, buddy.
There could not be a more opposite film for my number one as opposed to your number one.
I believe it. Really?
Yeah, buddy.
This is the
Human
third
Centipede 2. Yes, this is the third. Yes, this is Toy Story 3.
You actually liked it?
Buddy, they're all good.
Yeah.
Buddy, it was sad because it's about growing up and letting go. And at the time in 2010, I was 23, and I was at that time where it's like, you know, I have to grow up more. And
who
I didn't.
Who says that, though? Yeah, exactly. Who says that?
I did in the sense that I became financially secure and own a home. But other than that, you know, look behind me.
Yeah.
Like, look at this shit.
Those don't come to life.
That growing up. Buddy, can you imagine? My fucking crew would be lit, as the kids say.
I think even that term's old now.
I'm pretty sure it is, yeah.
It's not bad. I really got depressed when they all just held hands and accepted death.
Yeah, that was quite like, a moment. I thought that was the end of the movie. I thought this is how it goes. But
yeah, no. Claw! Fucking saved them.
Yeah, and the end scene was pretty sad where he gave all the toys to the girl and Toy Story 4 came out, and it was all right, surprisingly, but it didn't really need to happen. I don't know what the lesson was in that.
Never saw it. I should watch it. It's on Disney Plus.
Yeah, that's how I saw it. I didn't see it in theaters. But it does star Keanu Reeves as Duke Kaboom, Canadian Daredevil.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yep.
You're breathtaking.
Oh, fuck yeah. Should have said that in the movie.
I think that happened before.
It probably did. That movie was done a while before that ever happened. Yeah, like I said, it was a tough year. My buddy heard something. Are you being invaded?
No, it's like some Asian dude walking by singing.
Oh, right. He's happy. The world, didn't you hear the world's gone back to normal?
I don't know what he's happy about. He spread the fucking disease.
Jesus!
What? I don't know what race he is. It's just an open-ended...
You said an Asian guy singing.
It sounded Asian. Could have been an Italian dude.
Maybe.
I couldn't make out the words. I just heard a cadence, which sounded Asian or Italian.
Well, I'm glad you said it. You're exempt, because look at you.
Exactly.
This is our resident minority.
Yeah, I look brown as hell, but I'm white all the way.
You fucking just...
I was blocking the camera, buddy.
Yeah, is that what you were doing?
Yeah. There's too much light. I was blocking the camera.
Earlier off camera, you said, like, oh, we're just going to end up one day on the news. Like, local small market show a night at the movies, and here we fucking are.
It's not bad.
Yeah, and you get your fucking white supremacist tattoo there, the skull. The skull of your, like, Jewish victim or something.
Yeah, that's not fire. That's the hood.
Oh, got it. Okay, great. That's the smoke coming out of the stacks in Germany. Circa 1940.
Oh, fuck yeah, I should.
God. All right, everybody. I think we'll see you at the movies next year.
Not bad.